Welcome back to Market to Market. Crowdfunding is an alternative available to entrepreneurs seeking funding for their business ideas. This week on Marketplace 101, we chat with Ashmini Deunarain, one of the founders of Lewi Funded, a crowdfunding platform set to launch in Trinidad and Tobago this August. Let's talk about Lewi Funded. What is Lewi Funded?
So Lewi Funded is a project that was formed out of Startup Weekend, which happened in May, and that was where a bunch of entrepreneurs would get together and they vote on ideas that they think they would like to work on, and Lewi Funded was chosen and our team worked on it. It's a crowdfunding platform for Caribbean Indigenous projects where you could go online and post your project and get people to fund it.
What exactly is crowdfunding?
So crowdfunding is a way by which you get a large number of, a donation from a large number of people. It's similar to how we've done raffles where people would contribute to a cause. So it's like instead of taking $10,000 and going for a loan or going through traditional means of funding, you get $10,000 from from 10,000 people.
Why would an entrepreneur or business person choose to go through the route of crowdfunding as opposed to going through the traditional routes?
Through the traditional route, we found that people who are just starting their businesses and small business owners who don't have that much experience, they're seen as high risks if they go to traditional means of funding. So by coming to a place where people are only looking at your idea and they're looking at how interesting it is or how valuable it could be, then I think that's more appealing to a small business owner.
There are different types of crowdfunding. Mm-hmm. What are they? And are all of them going to be available through Lewi Funded?
No. So there are several types. There's one called donation-based crowdfunding where it's campaign, the contributors who come online to give money, they actually make donations and they get nothing back. There is equity-based crowdfunding, which is where when you contribute, you get a portion or equity stake in the company. And there's rewards-based, which is what Lewi Funded is, which is you contribute money on the site, but you get something back in return. So you get the project owners, people who put their projects online, get to see what the rewards are. So for different amounts of funding that you put on the site, so say for $0 to $100, I'd give you a t-shirt. For $100 to $200, I'd give you a sample of the product, that kind of thing. So you're getting something back.
Sounds interesting. Let's talk about the platform and how it would work.
So there are two types of audiences that we're catering to. The first is campaign owners or project owners who'd put their projects on the site. So if you're interested in, maybe a small business owner who has who makes some awesome jam that they want to get out there, they go on the site, they follow our guidelines, submit the project, they set a monetary target for how much money that they need and a time in which they need it by, and then we go through the submission to validate that you need to see this feature instead of something else. So it's a way of tweaking it, and then you could reintroduce it to the site.
Two alarm bells just went off in my head. Mm-hmm. One is, can you trust that the projects that people post online, and when they get the money, they're actually going to use the funds to execute those projects, one, and mm-hmm. two, I know a lot of entrepreneurs guard their business ideas closely to their hearts, and what you're asking is for them to put it on the internet, mm-hmm. where 6 billion people could see it.
Yeah. So to answer the first question, yes, by having it a rewards-based crowdfunding site, we want to encourage entrepreneurs to keep to their promise, and we're going to do checkups as well, because every project that we validate, we're going to ensure that the person has a good business plan, a solid business plan for how they're going to move forward. And it gives the added responsibility that if you're giving me $5 and I and $3 or $5 I was promising you a t-shirt or a sticker or a sample of my product, then that gives me added responsibility to meet those targets and to ensure that you get what, you know, because it's like a handshake. You give me something, I give you something back. So we're going to try to encourage that as much as possible. And we also want it to be not just an online, you know, not just on online platform. We want to encourage physical interaction as well and bring it to a physical space where we have like sessions where entrepreneurs could come who've had their projects on the site and talk to people and, you know, get support for their projects. People get to find out what they're up to, you know, what their plans are for the project. And I know that, you know, it's always this, it's always a big issue for people who are worried about sharing their ideas. But I think that if you put it on a site or if you're going to put it out to the public, to me that's a kind of, you're kind of copyrighting your own personal copyright on it then. Because people are going to see it. People are going to know that, you know, hey, John, you know, has this idea for this jam or pepper sauce or something that is his. And I also think that sometimes we're too guarded with our ideas. I think that if we let people in, you know, there are lots of ways that people could contribute. If you ask for help, people willing to give you feedback on your idea. I don't feel like people always, you know, they're gonna be helpful, they're gonna be open. And I've witnessed that at Startup Weekend, you know, going with my idea there and, you know, having these people come, like my five other teammates come around and say they're interested and they want to help out. It's been really great so far having that team around you. And I think that's what people need when they're starting off, small business owners especially.
So you just kind of have to hope for the good and the people to.
No, I think that, you know, I read something once where they say that, you know, people could copy your idea, but they can't copy what you want it to be. So your visions for the for what you want it to be, you know, they can't take that away from you. And to me, nowadays, there's so many ideas going around. It's hard to find like one unique original one, right? There's so many. So people put their different spins on it and their different twists and their own personality into it. So I think that it could be original. I mean, there are ways that you could, you know, secure your property rights, do your patents and everything. But I think when you're starting out, you really need support. You really need to know that, hey, I'm going to do something, people are interested in it, and they're interested in backing it.
Is there any reason why you all chose to go the route of rewards-based as opposed to offering equity?
I think that rewards-based is, for me, is a little more encouraging for the Caribbean community to be able to support them and get some, you know, a sample of their product or get something in return. It's kind of, it's a more, I think it's a stronger support system. You know, I think that people who just starting off may not, you know, I don't think that the equity would work as well in the Caribbean. You know, so that's why I think we went with rewards based.
So I have a business idea, mm-hmm. and I want to access crowdfunding to finance it. Mm-hmm. What do I do? Do you have any tips?
Well, you put your project on the site, and then, you know, you do your marketing of your own, because it's, you know, we're going to do our marketing to ensure that our site is out there, because the more people that are on our site, the more eyes on our site, the better the projects we do, the more successful campaigns we'd have. But is an onus on you as well to get your ideas out, to let people know that you're on the site, like help make my idea a successful campaign on the site.
Do you have any examples of companies that successfully used crowdfunding to support their business ideas?
I don't have specific examples, but there are huge sites like Kickstarter and Indiegogo, which we do recognize are competitors, but the difference that we see with them are that, you know, they don't offer, they don't let people outside of the US and UK submit projects online, submit projects to their site for crowdfunding. So, and we also felt like the Caribbean needed that extra push and entrepreneurs needed that motivation and somewhere where you could go to see what your fellow Caribbeans or Trinidadians working on and encourage them and provide that support to them.
Who would be allowed to make pledges?
It's open to everyone internationally, anywhere in the world, but we believe that the projects that we want to put on it should either be by Caribbean entrepreneurs or people looking to make a difference in the Caribbean.
In terms of paying and that kind of thing, I want to support an idea that I find on Lowry Funded. Do I have to use PayPal? How does it work?
Well, we're playing around right now with some different payment gateways. PayPal is one of the options. We're looking at SMS payment as well, so texting to short codes. We know that from our research, our market research at the start, you know, people have voiced their concern about the security of online payments. But we've also found that people have started using debit cards online or prepaid credit cards online then. So, you know, I think it is growing, and I think that the comfort that they have in the payment is knowing that you only get charged when the campaign is successful. So if you pledge money, you know, you're not going to get charged immediately. So you know, if it's a really good idea, then it's successful, then you get charged, and you know your money went to something that's been validated, something that will work.
Well, Ashmini, I just have one more question for you, which is, when can we expect the launch of Lowry Funded?
Well, we want to ensure that, you know, since it is a financial website where transactions would be taking place online, we want to ensure that we have something secure for consumers to use. And that takes some testing and, you know, we've started building the website already, and we're hoping to get it done by the end of August. So you could keep looking, checking our Facebook page, and we've our site right now. You could sign up for email alerts, so people could find out when we're going to launch.
And what's the website address?
www.lowryfunded.com.
Are you on Facebook?
Yes, we are. Facebook and Twitter, Google Plus. Yeah.
And we're searching for what? Lowry Funded?
Lowry Funded, yes.
Things, manual focus and white balance. He can bring all of the controls out at once. The ones that he adjusts are manual, the rest stay auto, so he gets the best combination of capabilities. We have also added to the Lumia 1020 rich audio recording.